नियतिकृतनियमरहितां क्लादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. इन् अप्रस्तुतप्रशंसा देर् आर् फैव् वेरैटीस्. कार्ये प्रस्तुते कारणस्य अप्रस्तुतस्य वर्णनं, निमित्ते प्रस्तुते अप्रस्तुतं कार्यं, सामान्यं प्रस्तुतं विच् इस् प्रतीयमानम्, एण्ड् देन् विशेष विल् बि अप्रस्तुतम् एण्ड् दट् इस् बीङ्ग् डिस्क्रैब्ड्. वेन् विशेष इस् प्रस्तुतम् एण्ड् प्रतीयमानं, सामान्यं दि अप्रस्तुतं विल् बि डिस्क्रैब्ड्. नौ द फिफ्त् वन्, देर् आर् फर्दर् डिविजन्स् इन् फिफ्त् वन्. Fifth one is where tulye prastute tulyasya aprastutasya. That tulyam can mean either something which is indicated with slesha or like a samasokti or just sadrishyam. The difference between slesha and samasokti here are actually, for slesha you have both the visheshana and the visheshyas will have double meaning. In samasokti, the visheshyam will not have the double meaning, only the visheshanas will be slishta visheshanani. Sadrishya matra hetuka also has three divisions there. So let's look at slesha first. The karika that starts off the tulya prastutam is tulye prastute tulya abhidane trayav prakaraha sleshaha samasoktihi sadrishya matram va. तुल्यात् तुल्यस्य हि आक्षेपे हेतुः. तुल्यात् तुल्यस्य आक्षेपः, तुल्यात् अप्रस्तुतात् समथिङ्ग् दट् इस् वेरि ईक्विवेलेण्ट् टु दि प्रस्तुतम्. प्रस्तुतम् अण्ड् अप्रस्तुतम् आर् वेरि ईक्वल् इन् नेचर्, वेरि सिमिलर् टु ईच् अदर्. इन् दट् यु हेव् श्लेष समासोक्ति अण्ड् देन् सादृश्य हेतुकम्. दीस् आर् द त्री वेरैटीस् इन् द फिफ्त् केटगरी. And slesha means where visheshana visheshya vachi shabdanam ubhayartha bodhaka param. Both the visheshana and the visheshya will have two meanings. In samasokti, visheshana matrasya ubhayarthata natu visheshyasya. So the, for the first one, udaharanam is pumstvadapi pravichalete yadi yadi adho api yayate yadi pranayane namahanapi syate. अभ्युद्धरेत् तदपि विश्वम् इति ईदृशी इयं केनापि दिक् प्रकटिता पुरुषोत्तमेन. पुंस्त्वादपि यदि प्रविचलेत्, अधः अपि यदि आयात्, प्रणयने यदि नमहान् अपि स्यात्, तदपि विश्वम् अभ्युद्धरेत् इति ईदृशी इयं दिक् केनापि पुरुषोत्तमेन प्रकटिता. सो द मेन् सेण्टेन्स् इस् केनापि पुरुषोत्तमेन ईदृशी दिक् प्रकटिता. Some great noble person has shown this path. Idrishi dik prakatita. He has shown himself to be in this manner. Now, what has he actually done? So, Purushottamena, actually the first thing that comes to our mind is Purushottamaha is Vishnu. That is the aprastutam. What did Purushottama do, Vishnu do? Pumstvadapi pravichalete. He had even removed himself from the pumstvam or purushatvam and became a stri in Mohini avataram to protect the world. Vishvam abhyuddharet, tadapi vishvam abhyuddharet. Even when he deviated from his pumstvam, pumstvadapi pravichalet, he protected the world. Adhaha api yadi yayat, adhaha nicha, even though he took the kurma form and went to the patalam or varaha murti, in both avataram he went down from his position. Where is Vishnu and Vaikuntham, and where is patala lokam, which is completely the opposite of that? So he was even prepared to go to a very low position. He was prepared to lower himself for the sake of the world. Vishvam uddharet yadi pranayane yadi namahan api. Namahan is a samasa here. Instead of you don't use a mahane, you say na mahane. That is a samasam here. So na mahan api vamana avatara, mahat swarupam na apitu alpa swarupam, so which is vamana avataram. Vamanatvam api prapya pranayane bhiksharupe. So bhikshayam he took a very small form, for begging. He even demeaned himself by begging. So and he took up the form of vamana avatara. Kimartham विश्वम् अभ्युद्धरेत्. सो तदपि विश्वम् अभ्युद्धरेत् इति ईदृशी इयं दिक् दिस् इस् द दिस् वास् शोन् बै सच् अ ग्रेट् पर्सन् हू इस् विष्णु. नौ द विष्णु इस् दि अप्रस्तुत वर्णना. द प्रस्तुतम् इस् अ किङ्ग्. अ कवि इस् टाकिङ्ग् टु अ किङ्ग् हियर् एण्ड् द अप्रस्तु द प्रस्तुतं बीङ्ग् द किङ्ग् इस् प्रतीयमानम्. So how does everything fit and all of those, even Purushottama is going to fit the king. So Purushottamaha Satpurushaha Atava Raja who is a great king, it can mean anything here. So Pumstvadapi Pravichalete, Pumstvam Purushattvam is an indicator for Shauryam, Viryam, etc. He can even let go of his Viryam to protect the world, not show his bravery in certain times. और अधः अपि यदि आयात् सम्पत् पोसिशन् यु नो ऐश्वर्यस्थानादपि सः भ्रंशेत् तदापि विश्वं यदि उद्धरेत् तर्हि सः एव पुरुषोत्तमः अस्ति. देन् नेक्स्ट् वन् इस् यदि प्रणयने न महान् अपि स्यात् याचने ईवन् इफ् यु बेग् and he is able to, even if he begs and he is able to protect the world, that is for protecting the world, he also can undertake begging or going and talking to people. Many people to, in order to save the world, they can take different forms or try to go to whatever extent. That is how they show their greatness, right? So, kenapi purushottamena prakatita. That is the prastutam, which is pratiyamanam. So, there is a slishta visheshana and visheshyapadam. So, slesha hetuka aprastuta prashamsa. If it had been the opposite, then probably, I think it would have been shabdashakti muladhuni. I'm not touching too much on it. If the prastutam is being described completely and each of the words had the power to give rise to another aprastutam meaning totally, then that would actually be Shabdashakti Mooladhvani. Just for distinguishing that.
So here, isn't the meaning of Vishnu more prominent than the meaning of the king?
Yes, so that is why if it is a kavi who is describing to the king or a kavi who is describing a satpurusha, then that will become the prastutam. So context decides whether this is a slesha hetuka aprastuta prashamsa or something else. If it is a purushottama who is being described here, it is a Vishnu stuti, then it is that Vishnu becomes the context here. He is not the aprastutam.
Okay.
So context is something only Vyakhyata can fix and tell us, right?
Yeah,
I think the context here, see, sapatna apakhritam rajyam uddhartum. The context here is, see, ballata kavikrita ballata shatake asti idam padyam. Sapatna apakhritam rajyam, shatruna apakhritam rajyam, tam uddhartum kanchitu nripam prati, kanchitu nripam udvejayataha mantrinaha uktihi. So a mantri is trying to instigate the king to go and fight. So, you know, do by whatever means you have to go and protect the world and recapture the kingdom from the Shatru, who is probably not a good ruler.
Okay.
So the context is fixed here.
Okay.
Next is Samasokti. Samasokti here, so here he says, Atra Satpurushe Varnani Yatve Prastute Sati Tatulyasya Aprastutasya Sri Vishnoho Abhidanam Tatra Pumstwadi Visheshananam Purushottamena Iti Visheshyasya Cha Sleshena. Both are in Slesha, Slishtapadani. Prastutasya Vishnu Tulyasya Satpurushasya Akshepaha. Okay, Akshepaha means Pratiyamanam. So this is Slesha Hetuka Aprastuta Prashamsa. The next is a shlokam where the context is Kshinadanaha Kaschite Upajivanartham Apakarinam Sadhanam Anusaran Kenachit Upalabhyate. So someone does not have any money with him and Upajivanartham, in order to survive, he is following a person who has Dhanam. So Sadhanam Kintu Saha Apakari Asti Natu Upakari. So the Dhanavan is not a upakari. He does not help him. He does not do any sahayam, but he actually creates more of a problem for the person who follows him and for the person who is Daridra. So when a third party looks at the situation, he ridicules the Daridra, saying, why do you have to follow such a person? Don't you have any self-respect? Don't you have to take revenge on a person who is doing apakaram to you? Instead of that, why are you following him? That's the import, that is the context here of the shloka. So the shlokam should be descriptive of an aprastuta, aprastuta section, right? Aprastutam, which is a Chandra and Surya Vrittantaha. Yena asya, yenasi abhyuditena Chandra gamitaha klantim ravau tatrate yujyeta pratikartumeva napunaha tasyaiva patagrahaha. Kshinena etad anushtitam yadi tataha kim lajjate no manak astu evam jada dhamata tu bhavataha yadvyomni vispurjase. येन अभ्युदितेन येन त्वं क्लान्तिं गमितः असि तत्र रवौ ते प्रतिकर्तुम् एव युज्येत. सो द फर्स्ट ही सेट्स द स्टेज हियर. हे चंद्र एड्रेसिंग द मून इज इज व्हेन द सन राइजेस योर प्रकाशम इज नॉट देयर. चंद्रस्य प्रकाशत्वं नास्ति, राइट? तादृशं प्रकाशत्वं नास्ति. Suryastu ati ativa prakashate. Yena abhyuditena yena, by that sun, when the sun rises, tvam klantim gamitaha asi, you lose your lustre, so you fade. Tatra ravau surye. So what is karya? What should be done here? Pratikartum eva yujyeta. It is only proper that you have to take revenge on the Surya, right? Because he has caused your lustre to go away. Na punaha tasyaiva padagraha. You should not go and catch hold of his feet here. Here padagraha, pada also means kiranam. So you should not go and borrow his light. So the idea is where. There are two things here. Padagraha also, Suryena Saha, Chandra, when he goes with the Surya, it is called Amavasya. And he loses his prakasham, and he derives his prakasham from the Surya's light. So it's only because of Surya's prakasha that Chandra also has its kanti. So here he says, na punaha tasyeva padagraha, you should not catch hold of his kiranam, of his light, and follow him. In other words, for the prastutam, don't, you're falling again at the feet of a person who is causing, who has caused this, daridryam in you. Or he does not respect you enough and he is torturing you, yet you are still going and falling at his feet. That is the prastutam here. क्षीणेन एतद् अनुष्ठितं यदि ततः किं लज्जसे नो मनाक्. सो यदि क्षीणेन त्वया एतत् अनुष्ठितं ततः मनाक् किं नो लज्जसे. सो इफ् यू आर् इन् अ वेरी इफ् यू डिड् दिस् वेन् यू आर् वेरी पुअर् क्षीणेन त्वया एतत् अनुष्ठितं चेत् tataha kim no lajjase, then why are you not ashamed of this? When you are in a very weak position, you have gone and caught hold of him, the same person, you have not caught hold of another person, the same person who has caused such a great apakaram to you, right? Tataha no lajjase, you are not even you are not ashamed of going back to the same person. Instead of that, astu evam, that is fine, but what you're doing is yatu vyomni vispurjase tattu bhavataha jada dhamata. You borrow that light from that Surya and you're also trying to show off that wealth. So vyomni vispurjase, you are shining, showing yourself in the sky to everybody that you have caught hold of that the same Surya who had insulted you, and you have taken his light and you are shining and showing yourself in the sky. What else can I say about this other than your jadata, jada dhamata? Dhamma is prakasha. So Chandra, the moon has a coolness. That coolness, shaityam, is also indicative of jadatva. So shaityam is its dhamma, that is its luster. And so it is showing off. He is playing on the word of jada also. And he says it is your coolness, or you just don't have, how to say, your without being ashamed, you are showing off yourself, that wealth that you have received from a person who is actually not giving you, not helping you, but he is torturing you. So the idea comes from that. He is only describing Surya and Chandra here. The Chandra Padam is not Slishtam, whereas in the earlier shloka, Purushottama Padam also went for both the Raja or the Satpurushaha and Vishnu. Here, Chandra does not apply to a Daridraha. You cannot have two meanings for Chandra, where one is Daridran and one is the moon, right? So the Visheshya Padam is Aslishtam, whereas everything else like Padagrahaha and all that indicates both the Sadhana Nirdhana Vrittantaha and the Surya Chandra Vrittantaha. Udayaha, Klantim Gamitaha, all of these can apply to both Daridra and the moon. Samasukti goes for that. So I am Aindri Mukham Pashya, Raktas Chumbati Chandramaha. If you look at the Samasukti examples that we have seen before, where only the Visheshanas have Slishtapadam, Anuragavati Sandhya, Divasastat Purasaraha, Tathapina Samagamaha. Oh, so all of those also have only the Visheshya Padani. Visheshya Padam is not Slishtam, whereas the Visheshana Padani are Slishtani. Next is Sadrishya Matrakam. There is no Slesha involved here. It's just a simple comparison. Adaya Vari, only one incident is present here. Aprastutam alone is described here, and the Prastutam is Akshiptam and the Pratiyamanam it is. So Adaya Vari Paritaha Saritam Mukhebhyaha Kimtavadarjitamanena dur arnavena kshariikritamcha vadava dahane hutamcha patala kukshi kuhare viniveshitamcha. Very nice. Let's see the context here. So Bhattendu Rajasya Padyam Idam Iti Kshemendra Krita Auchitya Vichara Charchayam Spashtam. He gives this for Apadana Karaka Anauchityam. He gives this as an example for that. Karaka Anauchityam. There is a description of a Dur Arnava. So what does the bad ocean do? Paritaha Sarita Mukhebhyaha Vari Adaya. The ocean takes water from all the rivers that are around. Saritam Mukhebhyaha, that Mukhebhyaha is Anauchityam. So taking water from the mouth of another person, it indicates Vamanam or Saliva and all that. Anauchitya, there is a disgust Garha associated with that. So he says it is a Rapadana Anauchityam there. After reading Auchitya Vichara, you keep thinking these are all, it's so apt here when he says, yes, yes, it is, you know, you want to say correct what Kshemendra says is correct. Auchityam has to be there for every word that you use in a shloka. Let's just see the alankaram here. So, dur arnavena arjitam, the ocean has earned, or he has, kim tavat arjitam, what has this dur arnava, this bad ocean, has earned by taking water from the mouths of all the rivers. So he has received water from the rivers. And what has he done with it? Kim anena, kim tavat anena durarnavena arjitam kshari kritam. The fresh water from the lakes has been made salty by him. Kshari kritam. Vadava dahane hutam cha. He has also burnt it in the Vadavanala, that submarine fire that is there, the Vadavagni. And he has put it inside that, if he has put that water, that Vadavagni has the capability of Jala Shushki Karanam Tasya Karyam. So it has been burnt there. Or the rest of it has also been pushed into the Patala Kukshi Kuhare Viniveshitam cha. And that water has also been pushed or thrown into the interiors of Patala. So this is about a spendthrift person. Here there are no comparisons. That is, there is no Slesha Padam. No, none of the words that are present here can be... the meaning, the direct vachyartham or by slesham, it cannot indicate the prastuta vrittantam. Prastuta vrittantam is about how somebody parebhyaha dhanam akrishya. He takes money from others. Asaddishaye vyayam karoti. He does not use it for proper methods. He only distributes it to in a for bad things. So that's why he gives Durarnavena Paritaha Sarita Mukhebhyaha Paritaha Vari Adaya. He takes water from the mouths of the rivers. And then where does he spend it? What does he do with the good water that comes from the rivers? Kshari Kritam. Lavanam. Right? He makes it salty. He burns it in the Vadava Anala. And Patala Kukshi Kuhare Viniveshitam. He also pushes it to the interiors of Patala. So sarvebhyaha sarvataha parebhyaha dhanam akrishya asadvyayam kurvane pumsi prakrite sati. That is the context here. Aprakritasya abdehe katanam tatra slesha abhave api. So there is no slesha here. Sadrishya matrena asatpurushasya akshepaha. So there is just a comparison between the bad ocean and an asatpurushasya vyavaharaha. Sadrishya matra hetukam. So after giving a general definition of this sadrishya matrakam, he says, iyam cha kachit kvachit vachye pratiyamanartha anadhyarobena eva bhavati. In some cases, there is no aropaha vachyasya. The meaning anadhyaropanam means here vachyasya aprakarnika arthasya. Vachyartham is here aprakarnikam, which is non-context. Sambhavitve na tatra sambhavitve. So the there are places only when you understand the examples will you understand the next two what is pratiyamanartha adhyaropanam and pratiyamana anadhyaropanam. Let me, you know, before going to the anadhyaropanam, let's look at the next sloka and then come back to this anadhyaropanam. Because adhyaropanam makes more sense. Only after studying this will we understand that. So, kvachit pratiyamanarthasya adhyaropena bhavati. How does that adhyaropanam work? If you look at the description of Durarnavam, Durarnavam, it is just a natural thing where he takes water from the rivers and it becomes salty in the ocean. That is a natural occurrence, which he has just described it in such a manner and used the word durarnava and mukhebhyaha adaya and all that to give the impression of as asatpurusha vyavaharaha, right? Here, this description of this shlokam is such that it is not possible in the world. And this can be made possible only by the pratiyamana prastuta katha. Let's read the shloka. I think we had this in Dvanyalokam. Kastvam bhoho kathayami daiva hatakam mamvidhi shakhotakam vairagyadiva vakshi sadhu viditam kasmaditam katyate vamena atra vataha tam advagajanaha sarvatmana sevate na chayapi paropakara karane margasthitasyapi me. Patikaha is asking a vriksha. A tree that is there, and that tree is Shakotaka. It is a tree which has just sticks on it. It doesn't have any shade. So the Pathika, the traveler, is asking a tree, saying, Tvam kaha. So Achetanasya, there cannot be a conversation by an Achetana, between an Achetana Vastu and a Chetana Vastu. It can only happen in stories or in Kavyam. But this makes more sense where if you superimpose the prastutam here. If you superimpose the contextual meaning here over the non-contextual conversation between a Chetana and Anacetana, Patika Vriksha Sambhashane, you take the Dushta Prabhu and Vrittantam here and superimpose it. Kastvam Boho, he asks him, Kastvam Tvam Kaha Iti Patikaha Pritsati. Tatra Shakotaka Vrikshaha Uttaram Dadati Boho Katayami. Daiva Hatakam Mam Vidhi Shakotakam. Know me as the tree Shakotaka. Daiva Hatakam. Daiva Hatakam means one who is hit by the fate. I have a very unfortunate fate. Know me as the unfortunate Shakotaka tree. So Vairagya Deva Vakshi is questioning, oh, why are you speaking so dejectedly? Daiva Hatakam iti padena tasya vairagyam suchyate. Tasmat patikaha prichati vairagya deva vakshi. It seems as if you are talking from vairagyam, disillusionment. So Vrikshaha sadhu viditam, you have recognized. So you understood that hint that I gave. Kasmadidam kathyate. So tell me, why are you speaking in this manner? Patikaha. So Vrikshaha vamena atra vataha. On my left side, there is this banyan tree that is standing. Advaga janaha, any other traveler who goes on the road, tam sarvatmana sevate. See, there is a pathway, and on the left side of the path, vamena, atra vatavrikshaha tishtati, tam vatavriksham sarvatmana, sampurnataya advaga janaha, patikaha tatra agatya, tasya chayayam upavishanti, sarvatmana sevante, janaha. Kintu marge eva aham tishthami, margasthitasyapi me para upakara karane na chaya api sevate. See, they don't give me the opportunity of, you know, I want to give them shade, but they don't want to come and sit under the Shakotaka tree. They don't want to sit here because I think the Shakotaka tree, Pantha janaha sarvatmana chaya bojanadi vyavaharaya tatra vatavrikshameva sevate natu mam sevante. Bhutavasatvena. See, that's what I was going to. Bhutavasatvena shakotaka chaya anashrayanam. It's famous for having a lot of ghosts, so nobody will go and sit under the Shakotaka tree. So maybe it is not a stick-like tree. Even if it is a tree with a lot of shade, still people will not go for fear of ghosts. So bhutavasatvena shakotaka chayayam na upavishanti janaha. Tasmat chaya api para upakara karane margasthitasyapi me. I am standing in the middle of the road so that I can give help to others. Para upakara karane. Para upakara karanaya aham marge eva tishthami. Tathapi chayapi na sevate. They do not come and sit under my shade for anything. So this is one with vairagyam or with the, is totally disillusioned by the actions of the people here. But the idea, what is the this thing that we get is prastutam pratiyamanam satpatrena swadattasya anangikarat ativa nirvinnaha. Satpatrena nirvinnaha swadatta satpatrena anangikarat. Someone has given his wealth to another person and he has not accepted it. Satpatram saha, but he has not accepted it. Adhama jati ditsuhu kaschit purushaha prastutaha. He says, because that person is from an adhama jati, nobody wants to accept it from him. Or it could also be a dushta prabhu who wants to give people because he wants to. What is that? In Kiratarjanim, there is a shlokam. Tatapi jihmas sabhavat jigishaya tanoti shubram yashaha. Tatha pijikmas sabhavad jigishaya tanoti shubham gunasampada yashaha. दुर्योधन गुणसम्पदा यशः शुभ्रं यशः तनोति किमर्थं नाट् बिकास् हि वाण्ट्स् टु डू पुण्य भवज्जिगीषया युधिष्ठिरं जेतुम् इच्छया सः शुभ्रं यशः तनोति सो तादृशदुष्टप्रभुः अपि भवेत् अत्र न सो इट् नाट् नेसेसरी दट् इट् शुड् बि एन् अधमजाति पुरुष वै गो इन् टु दट् ऐ बिलीव् इट् इस् मोर् लैक् दुर्योधन हियर् See, I am trying to do good things for others. But people understand the attitude behind that action. So if the attitude is not correct, then nobody will want to come and receive any goods from that person, or any charity from that person. So, tadrisha kaschit dushta prabhoho uktihi iti vaktum shakyate. Right? So here, achetanena vachyarthena shakotakena saha ukti pratyukti asambhavat. That is not possible. Achetana vastu is not possible. So how is that possible? Vakyarthe shakotakadirupe pratiyamanarthasya dushta prabhu aropaha. Avashyakaha. We will take it like that. So vakyarthe प्रतीयमानस्य आरोपेण एव वाक्यार्थसिद्धिः भवति अन्यथा अचेतनवस्तु केनाट् हाव् अ कान्वर्सेशन् सो वि नीड् दट् प्रतीयमान हियर् तादृशप्रतीयमानं विना अपि भवेत् ईवन् विदौट् एन् अध्यारोपं द प्रेसेण्ट् श्लोक इट् सेल्फ् केन् गिव् अस् दट् मीनिङ्ग् दट् इस् दि अर्लियर् श्लोक सो इट् विल् मेक् मोर् सेन्स् नौ टु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् दि अर्लियर् श्लोकं नौ इयं च काचित् वाच्ये क्वचित् वाच्ये प्रतीयमानार्थ अनध्यारोपेण एव भवति यथा अब्देः अम्बः स्थगितभुवन आभोगपातालकुक्षेः पोतोपायाः इह हि बहवः लङ्घने अपि क्षमन्ते आहोरिक्तः कथमपि भवेत् एष दैवात् तदानीं को नाम स्यात् अवटकुहर आलोकने अपि अस्य कल्पः दिस् ओशन् is looking at the ocean and says many people when it is full have tried to cross the ocean they use different types of upaya pota upaya pota is ships nauka naukanam upayena sahayena bahavaha abdehe langane kshamante they are capable people with the help of many boats they are able to cross the ocean how is this ocean which is filled with स्थगित भुवन आभोग पाताल कुक्षेः अब्देः अम्बः लङ्घने अम्बः वाटर् सो लैक् टु क्रास् द वाटर्स् आफ् दि ओशन् विच् इस् कवर्ड् दि एण्टैर् अर्थ् स्थगित कवर्ड् भुवन आभोग इस् एण्टैर्लि इट् इस् एण्टैर्लि कवर्ड् द अर्थ् until the ocean and the sorry until the patala kukshi means interior stomach so literal meaning is stomach here so patala kukshi until the interiors of the patalam and the entire earth because more than 75% of the earth is covered by water 70% of the earth so this ocean has covered the earth completely from the earth to a patalam sarvatra jalamayam eva samudrasya so samudrasya tadrisha so when it is sampurnam people have crossed and they are able to cross the ocean pota upayah bahavah janaah langhane samarthaah bhavanti aho parantu what happens is yadi riktah daivat kathamapi yadi esah riktah bhavet tarhi nobody will be able to even look at its that entire the bottom of the ocean see we don't know what it's like the you know National Geographic channel episode mysteries of the ocean so nobody has been able to chart the entire ocean floor completely the tallest mountains are supposed to be under the sea level It is not Everest. So the tallest, something which is taller than the Everest is supposed to be underneath the ocean. So if by any chance, by fate, if somehow the ocean were to be emptied, who can look at the holes and cavities that are there inside the ocean? Ko nama kalpaha samarthaha syat. Katham api kalpaha syat. Can anybody be capable of what? Avalokane, alokane. Kutra avata kuhara alokane. Asya abdehe avata kuhara alokane. Avata is holes. Kuharam is caves. Who has the capability of looking into the ocean? Now this is the aprastutam abdhi vrittantaha. The prastutam is actually, when it is a dushta prabhu, it's very easy to serve a prabhu or a raja who has a lot of wealth. Even if he behaves very badly, in some way or the other, we save him, serve him, and we do him some little help. There is a chance of getting some money from him. If such a personality does not have any money, then it is even, how can we even look at him? It's very difficult to even look at him. Think of the problems that we will face. We will be serving a bad prabhu and we won't be getting anything in return also. So tadrisham prastutam atra pratiyamanam. So atra upamardana shilasya, one who is capable of giving torture. Tadrisha dushta praboho purnatayeva varam. It is better if he has wealth in him. Na riktata. Riktata, if he is empty and does not have any wealth, if he is not prosperous, then it is atyanta upamarda apattehe. We will be tortured even more. Iti prastutam pratiyamanam. Atra vachyartasya swataha eva sambhavitaya. Na tatra pratiyamanasya adhyaropaha avashyakaha. We don't need the adhyaropam to explain this. By itself, we know that the ocean, it is possible to cross the ocean only when there is water and you have a ship to cross it. But if it is emptied by fate in some manner or the other, who can look at the ocean? It's something we don't even know what is there in the ocean. So that is quite plausible even without the adhyaropam, superimposition of the pratiyamanartha. Now this is more clear, right? After reading the Chakotaka shlokam, this is better. Kvachit amsheshu adhyaropena. Now the last variety of aprastha prashamsa is where in some of the places we need the adhyaropa, superimposition. In some places we don't need the superimposition. Yata, so apurvaha rasana viparyaya vidihi tat karnayoho chapalam drishtissa mada vismrita swaparadik kim bhuyasa uktenava sarvam vismritavanasi bhramara he yad varanaha adhyapi asau antashunyakaraha nishevyate iti bhrataha kayeshagraha. The aprastutam here is a description of the story, the actions of an elephant and a bee. Bhramaraha. The prastutam is sevya sevaka bhavaha. That's one very very favorite topic for him, I think. So saha apurvaha rasana he bhramara is addressing the bee and saying, see, you are constant. There is an elephant which is in its youth. So there is madajalam on the sides of its temple. That madajalam that comes from the temples are indicatory of an elephant which is in rut, which is young. So that madajalam is also fragrant. Sugandha madajalam. So it attracts bhramara. Bees are constantly roaming around its face, the elephant's face, continuously. And even though now the elephant keeps moving its ears constantly, it does not keep its ears steady. So it tries to wave away the flies and the bees. A kavi is addressing the bhramara here. The prastutam is different. Okay. So the bhramaram is like a sevaka who is constantly going and approaching a dhanavan. So karnayoho chapalam, he is the bhramara. All of these are descriptions of the gaja here, first few things. So saha apurvaha rasana viparyaya vidihi. Rasana viparyaya vidihi, it is One minute. There is a katha where the tongue of the I'm going to read from this small portion that is there underneath this. There are notes here where the Purana katha is given about how that elephant's tongue is viparyayam. Elephants also had the quality to speak like parrots and myna, you know, koel and all that. Some birds had the capability of speaking. Elephants also had that capability, but because of Agni Shapam, the tongue got viparyayam. So rasana viparyayam is the twisting of the tongue where the elephant could not speak after that. This is from the Shanmukha story. Purakila tarakaha nama asuraha chaturananath labdhavara balagarvitaha surana bahuda kleshayamasa. So Taraka was torturing people a lot because he got varam from Brahma. Techa suraha devaha tatkrita klesham asahamanaha na sahante. They could not tolerate it. Chaturananam sharanam jagmuhu. They went to Brahma. Chaturanano api suraklesham parijihirshuhu parihartum iccha asita brahmanaha. So devan avadat bho devaha agnehe sakashat kartikeyo nama putraha bhavita. Such a Taraka Asurasya Vadham Sampadayishyati. He will kill Taraka. Ataha Bhavadbihi Twaraya Agnim Anvishyatam. So go and search for Agni. Agni did not want to show his face at all. So he went and hid somewhere. Devastu Tadvachanam Upashrutya. He did not want to show because he could not take that torture anymore. Taraka Asura was torturing too much. So Agni went and hid himself. And he did not show his face. Devas went in search of him. Nilinam agnim anveshayantaha tam alabhamanaha. They could not find him. Kanchit mahantam gajam paprachuhu. They asked an elephant. Agnihi kutra asti iti. Saja gajaha devam prati aha. Ashwate agnihi asti iti. Ashwate. He is there in a tree. Ashwata tree. So tataha krodamurchitaha agnihi sarvana gajana shashapa. He cursed all the elephants. Yatha pratipa bhavatam jihva bhavitri iti. Pratipa. Pratipa means viparyayam. So let your tongue twist itself so that you will not be able to speak again. Mahabharate spashtam. So this is there in Anushanika, the Anushasanika parva in Mahabharatam. So the saha apurvaha rasana viparyaya vidhi. So elephant's tongue is twisted. Tongue is twisted means in the prastutam, how does it apply? Vachi vakrata. So there is a vakratvam that is there in the person you are trying to serve. I'm saying the parallel idea for the prastutam also, so it will be easier to understand. Saha apurvaha rasana viparyaya vidhi means vachi vakrata asti. Karnayoho chapalam. Karnayoho chapalam. The ears are constantly moving. Here, karnayoho chapalam is the ears are very fickle that it will believe whatever it is saying. So, if someone is trying to cheat you, he cheats everybody. That Dushta Prabhu, he cheats everybody. Parana vanchayati. Karna chapalam means he takes advantage of the fact that people are easily gullible. So he uses words that can cheat others. So that karnayoho chapalam sa mada vismrita swa paradik drishtihi. The drishti of an elephant is mada vismrita swa paradik. That mada jalam is actually an elephant which cannot control its temper. It indicates an elephant which cannot control its temper. So the drishti is completely, it forgets everything. No. Actually, it's not clear because of the path is not clear for it. Swa, para, dik. The directions of how another person should be, another person to behave, or which is good for me, which is good for others, that path is not clear because of mada garbha. For the elephant, it is madajala. So, kimba bhuyasa uktena, what more should I say now? Sarvam vismritavanase, you have forgotten everything, he bhrataha, you have forgotten everything. Yad adhyapi nishevyate asau varanaha. Katamasti asau varanaha, varanaha gajaha. Antashunyakaraha. he doesn't have anything inside his trunk. Dana vihinaha saha iti aprastutasya. Sorry, prastutasya. Kayesha graha, what is this agraham that you have? What is this attachment that you have to continuously serve a person who has nothing in his hand? And he only talks in a vakram manner. He cheats other people. His eyesight, the way he looks at things is not correct. He does not have the proper direction, or he is not clear in his mind, in his thinking. Tadrishasya sevane, what is the advantage of that? So the aprastutam here again, gajab brahmara varnana. Kvachita eva amsheshu adhyaropena. So in certain places there is adhyaropam. In certain places there is no superimposition, is not necessary. Now where it is not necessary, so karna chapalatvam, madajalam, all these things, brahmarasya gajasevane hetuhu bhavati. So rasana viparyayaha. Shunya karatvam brahmarasya asevane na hetuhu. There we need an adhyaropa of the sevya sevaka kata. Why does the bee go to the elephant? The bee goes to the elephant only for two things. Karna chapalam, it wants to go near the ear constantly. Why? Madha vismrita drishtihi. Because near its drishti and in the temple there is the madajalam, which is sugandha yuktam. And for that, the Brahmara, the bee goes and attaches itself to the elephant. Now here, the Prastuta Katha does not need to be superimposed because this itself works properly. The bee serves the elephant, or it goes to the elephant because of the Madajala. Hence, the two words are fine, right? Rasana viparyasaha is not now the where the adhyaropam is necessary, because rasana viparyasa and antashunyakara, we don't need these two for the brahmaram to go near the elephant. What is the necessity? Rasana viparyasa viparyaya vidhihi is not necessary at all. That does not even feature in the mind, that may not even feature in the mind of a bee when it wants to go near the elephant. It only wants that madajalam. So that rasana, why is the rasana viparyaya vidhihi mentioned here? So there we need the adhyaropa. The same way, antashunyakaraha, it is not going to go near the trunk of the elephant. For that also, we need the superimposition of the story. The sevya sevaka bhava is needed there. Without that aropam, we will not be able to connect the story. Just like how in Shakotaka. Okay? Hope it's clear. Huh? अत्र अप्रस्तुतयोः गजभ्रमरयोः अभिधानेन तुल्ययोः प्रस्तुतयोः सेव्य सेवकयोः. सो तुल्यं, बोथ आर तुल्यं हियर. गजभ्रमर कथा एंड सेव्य सेवक कथा इज तुल्यं हियर. इन दैट निर्विका निवारक अनुगतयोः. निवारक अनुगतयोः मीन्स निवारक इज अ पर्सन हू कीप्स ऑन पुशिंग हिम अवे. डोंट कम नियर मी. द एलिफेंट आल्सो सीम्स टू कीप पुशिंग द भ्रमर अवे फ्रॉम इट्स एंड सेज डोंट कम नियर मी. वेर इज द भ्रमर इज अनुगतम. इन द सेम मैनर सेवकः अनुगच्छति सेव्यः मा आगच्छतु इति निवारयति तम. सो निवारक अनुगतयोः पुरुषयोः श्लेष आक्षेपः इति अप्रस्तुत प्रशंसा. श्लेषस्तु क्वचित् एव वर्तते, क्वचित् नास्ति. सो इयं हि श्लेष इज देयर इन ऑल द एडजेक्टिव्स ऑफ यू नो रसना विपर्यय शून्यकर कर्णचापलम मद दृष्टिः. ऑल दीस देयर इज श्लेषम ऑल्सो देयर. इयं हि कर्णचापल अंशे वाच्ययोः गजभ्रमरयोः सेव्य सेवक पुरुष रूप प्रतीयमानार्थ अनध्यारोपेण. राइट, अध्यारोप इज नॉट नेसेसरी. तद अन्यत्र तु वेर रसना विपर्ययादि रूप अंशत्रये वी नीड दि अध्यारोप. रसना विपर्ययम् शून्यकरत्वम् इज इज मदजल दृष्टि आल्सो. नो, आई डोंट थिंक वी नीड देयर. जस्ट टू फॉर अनध्यारोप एंड टू अध्यारोप, दैट इज बेटर. ओके, सो कर्णचापलम् तु हेतुः मदः प्रति प्रत्युत सेवने निमित्तम. सो दट मदह बिकम्स द निमित्तम. दट ऑल्सो यू डोंट नीड अध्यारोप देर. ओके, सो बोथ टेक इट एज अनध्यारोपण एंड टेक एज रसना विपर्य एंड शून्यकरत्वम एज अध्यारोप. सो क्वचित अंशेषु अध्यारोपेण. नाउ ऑल I think we have seen 8 different types of aprastuta, where the three and three are actually 5 only. 5 main divisions. Let me go back to that. 5 main divisions of aprastuta prashnas are. The last variety had 3 more, and in that last variety also you had 3 more. Right. Next one is Atishayokti, which also has a couple of more divisions. We will look at that next class. Okay. Namaste.